We are ready now to listen to the words of the Holy Gospel, the good news of Jesus for us. Please stand and join us in the Gospel acclamation.
Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, a week after Christmas, we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Family. We know that the Holy Family and Mary, Joseph, and Jesus gives all of us an example for our own lives and our own family lives. They followed the prescriptions of the Jewish law. They brought the Christ child to the temple a week later for the circumcision, where he received his name, Jesus, and then they offered him up in the temple to Almighty God. And for all of us, we know as we go through life, we have to offer ourselves up to Almighty God in the best that we can. We look to the example of Mary, Joseph, and Jesus for their example. Family life is so important. We know we've all experienced different organizations that we might belong to where there's a bond that unites us together. So, for example, many of us are members of the Knights of Columbus or the Elks Club or the Ancient Order of Hibernians, and we're bound together in those organizations by a common bond. Same bond of religion or nationality that keeps us together. But in any one of those organizations, we're always free to resign from that organization and if we wish. The same is true, I think, if you've been traveled abroad, you've probably all had the experience of being in a foreign country, maybe standing on a street corner in Florence, Italy, or Munich, Germany, and standing there, and pretty soon someone comes up and you hear them speaking, and they're speaking English with the American accent. So you naturally would say, oh, you're from America. And they say, yes, and right away there's a common bond there, and you strike up a conversation with the person, asking where they're from, and if it's some place that you know, you might say, do you know so-and-so? I know somebody that lives there. And this happens frequently. It's a common bond that unites us together as Americans. And the same is true for other nationalities, of course. But even there, we know that we can renounce our United States citizenship. You can renounce your citizenship as an American and become a citizen of another country. There's one bond you can never renounce. You can never renounce your biological mother and father. Your parents are your parents, and that can never be changed. And so we have to work to make the family life a very important thing in our own lives. Some years ago, Reader's Digest took a survey, and they asked different questions, one of which was, if you had a family gathering at Christmas, and you had people over for Christmas, and it was a great number of people, would you feel comfortable asking your young child to lead grace before the meal? And most of the people said yes. We know that there's a common bond there. Gathering together for a Christmas meal is so important. It's one big family event that all of us take part in year after year when families do get together for the most part. But they said that prayer life is so important in a family. And in a family, there's three ways in which, or three times in which a person would pray. One would be they would pray alone by themselves. We know that many people get up and you say your morning prayers. Maybe you have a little prayer book, a little meditation book you'd like to refer to during the course of the day. Many people stop into the church to make a visit to the Blessed Sacrament. Everybody has a little different style of their own particular prayer life. But we all pray at different times by ourselves. And then we pray also, not only by ourselves, but as a family. And we pray as a family mostly at mealtime, when we say grace before meals. Maybe certain times we get together in the evening for evening prayer, or maybe say the rosary together. Father Payton, who led the family rosary crusade, who worked out of Albany for many years, used to say the family that prays together stays together. And he always encouraged people saying the rosary together. But we sometimes pray as a family together. And then we pray together in common, like we are today. So different families get together, as we do every week when you come to church. You're praying with members of the community, from all different families. And we pray together here at Mass, celebrating the Eucharist together. So we all pray in different ways. We know today family life is so different. It's not just a mother, father, and children. We know that today family life is so kind of distorted, mixed up. Sometimes there are families where there's just a mother and the children, and there's no father, or there's a father and there's no mother. We know there are dysfunctional families. There are families where people are just living together in common with no marriage bond at all. We have families where it might be invalid marriages. We have families where the parents are there with adopted children, which gives a little different outlook. And we know that at times it's difficult also because of the lifestyle of people today. We have, in most families, both parents are working, and the mother's working, the father's working, and maybe they're on different shifts. And very often, the only time the family gets together to even see each other is on Sunday for a Sunday afternoon meal, because they're different. All week they're on different work shifts, and never even get a chance to have some time together. So it's a very different style we find today, different family life. So you have to kind of work hard, because it's so important in a family to get together and accept the responsibilities of parents for their children, parents towards their spouse, to make family life, that's the basic unit of society. It's the most important unit of society. We're all part of a family. We all have to strive to really work hard to make our life and the family the most important thing, because that's where we have our best relationship with Almighty God. Today, as we start off a new year, tomorrow is January 1st, we're getting to the point of making all kinds of New Year's resolutions, and everybody always makes different resolutions to give up things or to try to do a little better in some particular thing. I think it'd be wonderful if we could all look at our own situation and our own family, take our own family life and try to make some kind of good resolutions within our family, be able to do something a little more during the coming year together as a family, not only prayer, but even doing things socially together, spending time together, and being there for one another, because the family is so important, such a basic unit in society. We have the example of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, and all of us should strive to imitate them, but to do the best we can to have a good family life ourselves, which certainly would be beneficial.